We have our packages, character model and animations imported into Unity. But to be able to try out our game later on, it's best for us to have a small test map. We'll go ahead and create one now, but don't worry as it's easy and fast. If you do not feel it's worth it though, I'll leave a link down below where you can download the final map. We'll be using ProBuilder to easily build it, so go to Window, Package Manager, and choose the Unity Registry Packages. In here, search for ProBuilder with no space in between. When it shows up, select the default version and install it. When it's done installing, go to Tools, ProBuilder, ProBuilder Window and dock it to the same tab as the Animator tab. We'll start by creating the ground by pressing on the new shape square with the plus icon. This will open a shape tool to select our object's shape and its size. Do note that for this to show up, you need to press directly on the plus icon square. You can also open this window by pressing Ctrl+Shift+K. We now have a preview of our shape in blue. Leave it as a cube and set its size to be 2000 by 100 by 2000. Press Build when you are done and close the window. Then I'll go to the Canis Prototype Texture folder and open up the Dark PNG folder and drag the texture 05 to the ground. This will create a material, so now press on the ProBuilder Material Editor window and assign this new material to the Alt 2 shortcut. If we now select an object and press Alt 2, our material will be applied to it. I'll add this ground to a new parent game object named Environment and also rename it to Ground. I'll set Environment Transform Position to -1000, -100 and 1000 to center it. I'll also drag our character model into the scene. When that's done, add a parent game object to the character model and name it Player. Reset both game objects' transforms. This will make it so that our player has a different object for its main component and its graphics. It doesn't matter too much, but you can also set the camera to 0, 1.5 and -1. Next, we'll add one small ramp and one big ramp with a small area to walk on. To do so, press Ctrl+Shift+K and choose the cube shape. I'll have the size of the small ramp be 5 by 1 by 15 and build it. Close the window and select the Edge selection icon. Select the top and edge and also the Move tool. Then hold Ctrl and pull the arrow upwards until you got around 6 squares. Then select the top start edge without holding Ctrl and then move it down until it's on the same level or close to the same level as the bottom ledge. We now have a ramp, but let's add our base to walk on by going to its back, select the face selection option and select the back face. Then press Ctrl E to extrude and move it with the Ctrl key held around 5 squares. When that's done, add this object to the environment game object and rename it Small Ramp. Then choose the object selection icon and move the whole object somewhere else you'd like. I'll also press Alt 2 to give it the dark texture. I would like for the top of the ramp to have another color though, so go to the orange folder and drag the texture 02 into the ramp, and then press Ctrl+C to undo it. This created a new material, so open up the Material Editor window and add this new material to the Alt+3 shortcut. Then select the face selection icon and then select the top face and press Alt+3. Let's also expand this small ramp to have a big center by extracting each side faces. Make it as large as you want. I'll have each side be 5 squares. Although we won't use it in the first part of the tutorial, our water will stay here. When you are done, let's add a ramp that goes down to the water. I'll select the bottom edge of the side I want to add a ramp on, and press Alt+U. This creates an edge on the opposite orientation, so now drag the newly created edge to be 5 squares from the wall. Then select the new face and extrude it with Ctrl+E, and drag it a bunch of squares. Now select the top edge and drag it down. Then select the top face and give it the orange material with Alt+3. Let's build another ramp by pressing Ctrl+Shift+K and make the set be 50 and build it. Make it a child of the environment game object and rename it to Big Ramp. Move it to a place you desire. I'll place it to the left of our small ramp. Then select its top and edge and drag it up as many squares as you want. When that's done, drag the top start edge down until there is a small step, which will serve as a test for our step climb. I'll also extrude the back face around 5 squares. Select the wall object now and give it the Alt+2 material. And then select the ramp face and give it the Alt+3 material. With that done, we'll now add a new cube with a size that fits our water area. Make it a child of the environment game object and rename it to water. Then go to our materials folder and create a new folder named environment. Inside, right-click the project window and go to create, material. I'll name it water. Change the rendering mode to transparent and make its albedo color a blue with a lower alpha. Then drag the material into the water game object. Next, remove its mesh collider and add a new box collider and set it to trigger. We'll also add two small rectangles to test something later on, so press Ctrl+Shift+K and build two cubes with a size of 4, 0.9 and 10. Name them Obstacle and add them as child objects of the environment game object. Then move them somewhere close to our player and separate them, leaving just a small gap in between them. I'll give this tool the red folder texture 04 material. And that's our base map created. Feel free to close or dock the tab somewhere else if you want to. If you don't want to close the ProBuilder window, make sure the Object Selection option is selected.